Hello everyone, happy full moon in Gemini for November 22nd, 2018. So we're going to start off with Gemini and I'm going to work my way back to, maybe I'll go to Taurus after that, okay? But I usually start off with Aries, so I'll see what happens. All right, it's a lot to say. So Gemini is in the 10th house, and the 10th house is about your career, and it's about you communicating with others. As you know, Gemini is the air sign, and it's about dealing with other people's emotions for this full moon period, maybe 3 days before the full moon and 3 days after. You can feel this energy of really reacting to other people's personalities or what they have to say, and really feeling like you're more in control of what you would say. And if you say something, you're really not worried about how others will think of it. So it's in the 10th house of career, and you want to feel free where you can express yourself, and you are reacting off of how others are reacting to you. So being in the 10th house, you're focusing on the career, your goals, about structure, and this is the only thing that is really with Gemini right now. There's no other planets around other than the moon. So emotions are very strong. You want to manifest things, get things done your way. Okay, and across from you in Sagittarius, they have Jupiter, they have the sun, because it will be Sagittarius season, and they have your planet Mercury in retrograde. So it's always good as a Gemini or any sign to look over to your opposite side on the chart. So Sagittarius has a lot going on right now, but we'll get to that later. So the main thing I want to mention is 0 degrees 52 minutes. So 0 degrees is more about like starting over. Maybe you've just gained experience in something, reincarnation. So it's all about just starting over. And it's related also to the Fool card in tarot. So if you look at what the Fool card means and try to apply it to your life, and everyone that's watching this as a Gemini or other zodiac in the charts, you'll have to relate it to your particular chart, okay? And if you want your charts done, then contact me for a personal reading if you'd like that. But the main thing to focus on, and I really don't take a lot of readings, I don't, but with the 0 degree, it's all about new beginnings, starting over, a new cycle. Maybe you've completed something. Maybe as a Gemini, you just learned something or you just mastered something and you feel really good, but you're still open to learn new things. So that 0 is a completion, is a starting over. And something cool about 0 degrees, if you were born and there's a planet that had a 0 degree, it was at a pause, or it was at a standstill, if you will, for your life purpose, your life flow. So Saturn makes its cycle around the sun every 29.4, so that's like 30 years it takes to make its full cycle. So when you turn 30, if you have any planets that was in the 0 degree, then that planet will start to be more active. So for the first 30 years of your life, you really were not needing that planet for your life lessons, is a way of looking at 0 degrees in your chart. But being that it's Gemini, and even if you're Gemini and Gemini degree is not 0, or if it happens to be 0 and you are 30 now or 31, then it's like, okay, you are really ready now to connect to the qualities of Gemini, communication and so forth, where the beginning 30 years of your life, you were more focused, or you should be more focused in learning lessons related to the other planets and their aspects and what they teach us, okay? So now it's like mastering the number of 0, if you will, or just mastering that particular quality of that planet, all right? So let's look at other things that Gemini can learn in this moon. So getting used to change and things changing for you, getting yourself a lot stronger to be open to learning new things. If you're Gemini and you've been resisting learning something new, Even though you know it's not a big deal, but you just feel like, you know, I really don't want to do this, or you don't feel like you should be bothered with it. This is a time where you can say, okay, you know what? This is not really a big deal. I'm just resisting this change. So being open to things changing and things happening a little bit differently, but it will work out good for you. Your personality will bring you through it. And it's just letting go and just moving forward to this new beginning. So I'm going to jump over to Aries, okay? Because I want to, you know what, let me just go to Cancer. I don't want to go back and forth. So if we look now at Cancer, it's all about for you to stop working so hard and making things more difficult for yourself, okay? You have the North Node in your 12th house, and your 12th house is about you healing and just ending things, but that aren't working for you, or that you're doing that is not a benefit to you. But the main thing that came through for Cancer is to really work through your everyday conflicts. So if things seem harder for you on a day-to-day basis, it's because you're not as spiritual as you need to be, your spiritual awareness, and also using your imagination to solve your problems, but also imagination as far as your meditation. That will help you to get through whatever conflicts you're going through and finding that solution. You know, going any deeper would be just speculating even more, but it's more on a personal level when you're getting these videos from me, is see how they apply in your life, okay? So the North Node and the South Node are always opposites on the chart. So for you, Cancer, the North Node is retrograde, right, in your 12th house. And your 12th house is going to be, like I said, healing, finding closure for things. These are the main things that you want to focus on. There's many meanings to the 12th house, but that's the main thing, and just having a spiritual awareness for yourself. Now, the South Node is in the 6th house, opposite you, in, I want to say, Aquarius, okay? Yes. So you want to make sure that you are looking over at what's going on in Aquarius's chart with Lilith, okay? And we'll get to that later, but looking over at your opposite sign will also help, okay? And I want to say your opposite sign is Capricorn, but looking over at Capricorn will actually help. All right, correction. So now, Cancer being in the 12th house, you will also want to be more intuitive towards yourself. So what is your needs right now? Okay? So really focusing on what you need and not allowing other people to use you, 'cause being in the 12th house, you're in Pisces house, and it just reminded me of what I'd written down for Pisces to focus on for this particular full moon. So you want to make sure that you're protecting yourself, you're protecting your energy, and that you're not caring so much that you're being used, okay, or you're being taken advantage of, all right? And this is very important. No one wants to feel this way, okay? So just being spiritually aware is the main thing. My notes are so messy. I'm gonna have to like do a printout paper. And using your imagination will help you to get through any of these day-to-day conflicts and struggles. And that's like the main thing. It's everything is just coming on very strongly, okay? And you need your space to breathe so you can take your time and grow and do things your own way. And especially if you're roommating with someone, that could be really hard for you, Cancer, okay? Yeah, messy notes. Starts out neat and then it's like, oh, I want to write more into it, and I'm like, this one sheet is not gonna do it. Okay, so Leo is in the ascending. So Leo, you're in the ascending of the first house of Aries. So people are gonna see you as more like an Aries energy, right? Where you're putting yourself really first. It's like fire meets fire, we meet fire. For me, what I notice is if a particular zodiac sign is in another house that is the same element, it just magnifies things. So Leo in the ascendant position, you're going to want to feel like you want attention, number one. But people are going to really see you acting in a way of Aries, where you're putting yourself first. You will also, the main thing is that your personality, your appearance, you need to make sure that it's not too much over the top. But the thing that the first house will help you is to really think about yourself. If you happen to be, especially for the Leos that are very sensitive and very giving, and if you're giving too much, where you know another sign is more powerful than your Leo, then for you Leos, being in the first house will really help you to put yourself first and just try to balance out any overthinking that you might do. That will just end up ruining relationships. And there's nothing, no planets in your sign right now, but you can look over to Aquarius, who is your opposite. Okay, the air sign of Aquarius is directly across with Lilith in Aquarius. So you want to look over to Aquarius chart for some strength in overcoming any kind of relationship problems, especially with friendships, okay? But being in the first house, it's all about yourself and how you're approaching your life and just getting your identity in check. Like, where do I want to go? What do I want to do? What changes do I need to make? Okay, so let's look at Virgo. Virgo the Virgin, right? Virgo is in the second house, money, income. You're in Taurus's house, another sister, brother, earth sign. And you want to look to Pisces to see what's going on over in Pisces to see where you can draw strength for your own life, because your opposite sign is doing things the same way but attacking it a different way. Okay, and they got Chiron over there in Pisces, right? And they also have Neptune and Mars. Okay, so we're gonna get to that in a minute, okay, because that's like the meat of the full moon in Gemini. The moon, Mars, and Jupiter connection, that T, okay? So we'll get to that soon. Now, being in the second house, you want to think about your money and your income, okay? And everyone is affected by their daily life routine. It's like, how can you improve it? How can you make it better? What do you need to let go of? Everyone's affected in that way. But Virgos want to make sure that their second house is intact. And your second house can also be about you controlling your money. So a lot of Geminis, if you're in business with someone else, Virgos. So a lot of Virgos, if you're in business with someone else, you're going to want to take control of that, of all of that, any kind of contracts, any kind of, like, even, it doesn't matter if you're running a big company, if you're running a big company, or you are roommating with someone, or even if you're signing a lease, buying a house, you want to make sure you have the upper hand, Virgo. This is really important, especially if you're dealing with someone that have more life experience than you. You're going to want to protect yourself, Virgo, because this person can know more than you, because they're more experienced in the field. Right, it's not a knock on Virgo, it's more like protecting yourself. So make sure that you seek advice from someone else where it has to do with your money and your income and your daily life routine, so that you have the upper hand. Okay, so even if it's renting a house, renting a condo, renting an apartment, you know, there's going to be contracts that's not going to be fulfilled, and if you're going to sign something, and you shouldn't, because Mercury's in retrograde right now. And even before this full moon coming up, because, you know, remember I always say after the new moon, you should have already been making changes already to have more control, or make sure that you're not in a position where you'd be taken advantage of. Okay, let me just end it right there. Okay, so now Libra. Okay, Libra, the scales. Okay, so Libra has Venus. Venus is telling you what you're attracted to, what you want as far as money, your success, what you need to be in control of, what you view as beautiful. Venus is showing you what you are attracted to, how you want to receive love and affection. So if you're in a relationship, let your partner know what you like. If you don't, they don't know this, and you could be missing out on a good person. Make sure that you're not being too critical or judging someone else too much because of what you think they're not doing as far as, aesthetics, like how they look. And maybe it's just more of you just should be creative in the arts or just look at something beautiful just to kind of fill that need, right? Not to say that your partner isn't beautiful, but it's more of you just finding, it's just heighten more what you're attracted to, okay? And maybe just focus that energy on yourself, and also, if you say what you like, you will receive it, right? So for this full moon, it's kind of like for everyone too. If you're not saying what you want, you're not gonna get it. It's just not gonna happen. And it's a Gemini full moon, so it's all about you communicating what you want and what you need. Okay, so we're gonna go, and then Libra is looking over to Aries and what's going on over in Aries, which we'll get to that. Okay, now we're gonna look at Scorpio, the Scorpion, the fourth house of home. You're in Cancer's home of family and self-care. So Scorpio's mode should be looking out for yourself, doing things that you need to do for you to make sure that you're okay, and not projecting anything on anyone else. It's more about you just taking care of yourself so that when you're making this switch over now to December, January, and February and starting the new year, that you are ready for that new year. And for all zodiac signs, you should be already preparing yourself for winter, preparing yourself for the new lunar calendar. Okay. All right. So Sagittarius, the Archer. Okay. So Sagittarius has Jupiter in the fourth house, and you need to take care of your mother figure. When Jupiter is in the fourth house, you need to take care of anyone that's your loved one. So someone that you know really needs help. So either health-wise issues, it could be mental, it could be physical. So if that applies to you, then taking care of that person when you have Jupiter in the fourth house, okay? So Scorpio has fourth house, but Sagittarius also has a strong fourth house as well. Okay, it's really close. So really caring about the person that you view as nurturing to you. Okay, so for some of you, it might not even be your biological mom. It could be someone that's nurturing to you. So that is something to mention. You might feel like you want to get things done because you have that Jupiter energy and other people are too emotional or too passive with you, but maybe they just want to know that you care or whatever, but they have to work it out themselves. You will find that people are acting really passive, and it's because it's what's going on in Pisces at the moment, okay? And it's not a reflection too much on you, really. It's more about their energy and how they're acting, okay? And it's more of the position of Lilith in Pisces and Mars and the moon and Jupiter. So it's all of that T square that's making people not really communicate in a kind of a roundabout way. And I'll get more into that later. But for Sagittarius, you want to just make sure that you are communicating the best way you can. And also not communicating will also help you since Mercury is in retrograde and Mercury is in retrograde in your sign. So you also want to just make sure that you are just, if someone is acting too crazy, just not really communicate with them and they'll work it out on their own. Okay? Capricorn. Capricorn has Saturn. Capricorn also has Pluto. So the main focus for Capricorn is people are going to expect you to do what they expect you to do, but you have to know yourself and know what you want. So if you feel like things are kind of going haywire the 3 days before the full moon, during the full moon, after the full moon, and even just leading up from the past new moon, it's more of the pressures you're putting on yourself, what you expect of yourself, but also doing what other people expect you to do is going to cause you more stress, okay? And you want to make sure that you know yourself and know what you want and act on that, okay? And with Capricorn being in the fifth house, it has to do with romance and love and relationships. So if you are in a relationship, and there's any issues, it's more dealing with your own personal mind and what you're trying to work out, maybe at work or with family or non-romantic relationships. All of your other relationships that have nothing to do with your love relationship, trying to work through that will cause the conflict in the relationship. So what you want to do is to really find your own joy and focus on that and let go of worrying about what other people expect you to be. That's causing conflict for you, and then that's going to affect your personal life and the romance life. But usually Capricorns will want someone that is older than them, that is responsible usually, and that can take off the burden and the worry, especially if you have like family and finance issues and things like that. And if you are single, then you will want, normally a true Capricorn will want someone that is responsible or even more responsible than they are, or more together from their perspective than they are. So it's really just making adjustments and allowing yourself to also in this full moon is in Gemini to kind of be more free. And I think all the signs will kind of take it easy on themselves, and if they're not, they realize that, hey, I need a shift, I need a break. So a lot of you might end up going away on vacation, and we have like the holidays coming up for our part of the world, but for Thanksgiving coming up, maybe doing something a lot different. A lot of Sagittarius will feel to do something a little bit different. Geminis will feel that, and Capricorn will definitely need it. Cancer will also need it as well. Okay, just to do something that lightens up the mode, maybe not take on so much responsibility for the holidays will also help. Okay, so Aquarius, like I said, Aquarius has Lilith in the sixth house. Okay, and the sixth house has to do with health, and fitness and so on, but mainly health for most Aquarius. Make sure that your health is in check. Just taking care of your health is really going to be important for Aquarius. And Lilith is going to want to make you rebel, but Aquarius, you're going to feel so much responsibility for something or feel pressured, but you're going to feel like you just need to escape your daily routine life and make sure that you put your health first. If you don't feel well, really trust your intuition, trust your instinct, because that dark black moon of Lilith is about you really taking your power and not feeling like you're pressured to do something that you don't want to do. So if there's something you feel like you're refusing to do, because this is like the Lilith energy versus what you are attracted to. So maybe something that you want to do that you feel like you're going to get a lot of flack for and you're not going to do it, but then at the same time you're refusing to do something else. Okay, so there's two conflicts here: what you're refusing to do and what you are feeling called to do or attracted to, but you know that it's going to cause a lot of like controversy. So It's really you handling the conflicts of whatever dilemma you're going through right now. And you would have to know what you're refusing and what it is that you're attracted to that might be not out of the norm, okay? So, you know, even with the holidays coming up, what if you want to do something a little bit different and you're feeling pressured to be a part of something that you don't want to be a part of, right? So what can you do to help uplift you? And looking over to your opposite sign, Leo, for some encouragement. So if you know someone that's a Leo that has a really strong personality that you can actually trust and confide in, then they will help you to lift your spirit and to help you to move forward and to just kind of get your strength and energy back, okay? So that's like the main focus. And just really looking at Pluto and seeing how it relates to you, what you can do to actually just benefit you, benefit what you want to do, okay? And I think I also mentioned the South Node as well. So let me look through my messy notes. Give me a moment. I never like to pause. That's like my thing. Okay? So, and a lot of with the South Node, let's just give it to you, the South Node. A lot of Aquarius are dealing with past issues, okay? So either past relationships, issues from that, past life, you know, but mainly I feel like it's past relationships is also on weighing heavily on your mind, okay? And that can cause that dilemma. And with that Lilith, it's kind of like losing power, rejection from maybe the last relationship or something. Maybe you rejected the person, they rejected you in some way in that relationship, and just making peace with that rejection. Maybe it's not like, oh, I don't want you, or maybe you said no to a date or no to any date. It doesn't have to be romantic, it could be family, but maybe it's just a rejection of something that you wish that you did with that person and you didn't get to do. But not allowing that to eat you up, you know, it's just working through that emotion. Okay, and I think that was one of the other things that came to me was it was helping you to find your balance again and help you to and inspire you to lift your mode and really connect to Leo. So really look into your opposite sign to draw strength, especially when you're feeling down. Okay, it doesn't have to be a full moon or new moon. It could be any day of the week, and you can see, okay, what's my chart like? Or how am I feeling? And even if you don't even know how to read the charts, who cares? You just want to draw power from or inspiration from your opposite chart sign to help you go through what you're going through. That's another cool technique that can be used in astrology. So for Pisces, you have Neptune retrograde, you have Chiron, and you have Mars. So it's all about being intuitive for yourself, trusting yourself, and healing yourself, and fighting for yourself, Pisces. In short, Pisces will feel like some of you might be going through issues where someone is using you, taking advantage of you. Mercury squaring Neptune will make it, you'll feel like you're changing your mind, indecision, okay? Not expressing yourself well, this is the thing. Too much daydreaming, because reality might seem like too complicated, so you're like, I'm just gonna daydream, okay? Getting used by other people. Pisces are very compassionate. All the water signs are very giving, compassionate. So make sure that you have like your own strong backbone. Like, you know, if you're out of relationship, try not to jump back into a relationship again, because that will cause you to really not think clearly. So, you know, you're gonna have that issue, okay? So the main issue for this full moon, it's a strong effect with Pisces, okay? So Pisces, you're gonna want to really work on yourself with Mars, okay? Protecting yourself, protecting your energy. And you might feel like you don't want to fight or argue with someone, so you're going to be indirect to get the things that you want done. But that's going to take it a lot longer. But if you want to play that game and say, okay, I'm going to be really indirect in dealing with this person because you feel this is the best way to deal with this person and their personality and the way that they're approaching you, then do that. You know, maybe that's your owl, your way of being wise in the situation. But Mars is asking you to work on yourself and say, hey, how can I be stronger for me in this situation? Okay? And now let's look at the T. You have Jupiter in Sagittarius. It's Sagittarius's season. Okay? You have the moon in Gemini, all about communicating your emotions back to Sagittarius with Jupiter. Okay? It wants to get things done, but there's a pause. There is the effect of Mars, where it's really you fighting to communicate. So there's going to be, for this new moon, it's really trying to communicate. And once you can get through this communication without a negative aspect of fighting for it, and how can you move forward, right? So there's two ways you can look at this. How can you move forward without a big fight, okay? And another way of looking at it is, how can you do things a little bit differently so that you can avoid making things worse for yourself, okay, or for others? So it's really a moon of communicating and fighting for oneself to move forward, okay? So everyone can learn with all the aspects, you know, especially Aquarius, what Aquarius is going to be going through, okay? That's pretty strong, okay? And then Libra with Venus, okay? Trying to find out what they love, and maybe if you are away from someone you care about, you miss that person, and you know, you're thinking a lot. You know, it's a little bit of that third house issue for Libra, and it's a lot, okay? And everyone is just trying to move themselves forward, fighting for themselves, okay? And communicating with themselves. And remember, it's Gemini in that 0 degree, so it's like the Fool card. It's like starting over, new beginning. And give yourself credit for something that you did that was a big step. You know, with the 0 degree, it's like reincarnation. It's starting over again, something new. Okay, it's a completion of a cycle, of an experience, okay? So just not being hard on ourselves, you know, and being able to change, because Gemini is a mutable sign. So all these six mutable signs, okay, think about how hard it is for you to change and then trying to make someone else change, right? So you have to work on yourself. And that came to me like 3 days ago. It was like, you can't change how another person treats you. You can't change how you're viewing that person. You know, everyone sh needs to shift and change a little bit here and there. So just being understanding of not understanding someone else. You can only understand yourself, and then allow people to be themselves. And if they come around, they come around. If they don't, they don't. But things are always changing, you know? And making sure that you're fighting for yourself first. You're communicating with yourself what you want first before you can communicate with someone else. And then you're really, I don't want to use the word fighting again, but Sagittarius is like the traveler, right? And it has Jupiter, so it's like it really wants to move forward. But and I'm looking at Sagittarius because Sagittarius is opposite to Gemini, so the energy is like, okay, I want to communicate, but you have to do it. Some of you guys, especially Pisces, have to do it in kind of like a sneaky backwards way just to not have issues, right? With someone else, just to not have issues. Now, I don't want to skip Aries, and I knew I would forget that. Okay, so with Aries now, Aries has, Aries is the pioneer, the trailblazer in the ninth house. The ninth house is all about travel. You're in Sagittarius's house. So travel and wisdom, okay? And just knowing from your experience, Aries. So Aries has Uranus in retrograde, okay? So at 29 degrees, 23 minutes from my area in the West Coast. So Aries, you'll be noticing sudden changes, unexpected opportunities will happen just from those changes and how you handle them. So handle these changes the best way you can. Things that happens really fast, okay, like accidents or first love or first love at first sight, you know, something that is going to happen for you guys that's going to be a sudden change, okay? And you just think of the aspect of Uranus, of things happening suddenly or fast change, and then really being in Aries, you gotta just adjust to that, okay? But the ninth house, and I was talking to an Aries today, so the ninth house, for a lot of you, it could be travel. Maybe you don't want to travel. Maybe you don't feel like socializing for this holiday, Thanksgiving. Maybe you want to just be by yourself to study or to catch up on studying if you need to catch up on work, catch up on something that you have to study, you know, that to make yourself better. Maybe relationships. Maybe there's a particular person you want to spend time with, okay? For a lot of you, maybe you're going through a spiritual shift, anything to do with philosophy and thought. So maybe you feel like you don't really want to participate, okay? And that could happen to Geminis too. Maybe you're just going through a life change, a shift, okay? And then look at this is something cool that came to me too. Look at the degree of the planet, and then that number, and then, you know, looking up the numerology for that number, okay? And see how you can incorporate that in your moon reading for yourself, okay? But know that the Fool card is very important for this full moon that's starting over again, and willingness to learn and to have new experiences, okay? So I hope you guys enjoy this reading. This one is pretty cool for me, looking it over. And just remember that the main thing for this is you communicating with yourself and fighting for yourself so that you can expand, so you can grow. Even though Mercury is in retrograde, it just means that you're just going to have to, with your communication, it's going to be a little bit more harder, trickier, not agreeing to new things. We know that in Mercury retrograde, and just taking our time with communicating with people, you know, being more patient with someone that's annoying. You know, just taking our time. Okay, I hope you guys enjoy this. This has been a long video. But happy full moon in Gemini. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.